There he goes, in reverse. Drunken reversing box-headed cat.
Is anyone going to help it, or are you just going to stand around and laugh?
Save him. There you go.
Finally, the cat is free. But it's not just boxes they like to get into, but also bins. And more bins.
Yay!
And hamster balls.
There's something about cats that they enjoy kind of restricted spaces. I've had tiny little boxes that my cats have tried to get into, and they kind of spill over the top. It's like a puddle of cat, and they sit looking at me. It's kind of like if I tried to get into a size 8 suit and then looked at my friend and went, what do you think? You kind of have to go, oh yeah, that looks, yeah, fits great.
And they're getting into loads of other stuff too, including sleeves. Plant pots. And even suitcases. But it really is boxes they like the most, and it seems we like them too. This is Maru, who's an internet superstar, and when he's not busy diving at boxes, he's found time to write 2 books. Oh man, I've heard it all now. And this clip of kittens in a tissue box got over 16.5 million views. Yeah, I'm sure that's exactly what the inventor of the internet had in mind when he legged it down the patent office.
I think the best thing you can send a cat owner for their cat is just a box. It's the warmth, it's the enclosure, it's the feeling comfortable, just security, I suspect. But yeah, every cat loves boxes.
Now, cats, as we've seen, can be as cunning as they are cute. Something of an understatement when it comes to our next feisty feline, Dusty. No, don't be fooled by his lovable appearance, because, ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at a hardened criminal.
Stealthy, quiet, opportunist.
We've got a real cat burglar here.
A cat burglar who's been prowling the streets of San Francisco for the past 6 years.
I would always get the newspaper in the morning, and as I did, I started noticing socks and stuff out there. I was trying to figure out why people would throw socks on our lawn. Gene was the one that figured out that it was actually Dusty bringing this stuff home.
We've gotten towels, shoes, underwear.
He's brought home a baseball mitt.
Balloons. He brought home a bag of balloons once.
One time he brought home a scuba flipper, lots of stuffed animals, lots of rubber balls, bathing suits.
And as time went on, this one cat crime wave took on increasingly ambitious jobs.
One morning there was 2 bags of like bolts out in front. I weighed them, they're like a pound each. And I took them over to the neighbors, asked him if they were his. And he said they had been looking all morning for those.
Gene and Jim wanted proof, setting up CCTV cameras to be sure this wasn't a case of mistaken identikitty.
When he steals something in the videos, you could just see the determination. Even if it's big and bulky, he just doesn't seem to want to quit. He just keeps going.
To date, Dusty, who now goes by his alias Klepto Kitty, has stolen almost 1,000 items, and his owners are powerless to stop him.
We tried keeping him in, actually, for a little while, but he was so sad. He would meow, and then he would sit by the door and just bolt out whenever he could. So we figured we can't really keep him in all the time. We had to let him out.
But the good news is that, like so many internet stars, Dusty's delinquent behavior has brought him worldwide fame. Who says crime doesn't pay? Although, obviously, it doesn't for any kids out there. Cats are widely known to be solitary animals. In fact, they'll often go out of their way to avoid crossing paths with other moggies. They don't even like cat statues. Or will simply refuse to wake up for another puss. But they do sometimes form unlikely friendships with tortoises. And hedgehogs. Lizards. And even dolphins. But most of all, they really do love us humans. Especially when, like in this clip, they get over 70 million hits on the web. I hope the owner bought that kitten a lot of smoked salmon with the proceeds.
What's interesting about cats, for instance, you know, the cat using the tortoise as a mode of transport, just underlines the fact that cats are lazy, selfish, but they also have a massive overriding sense of entitlement, you know. Cats think that everything else on God's earth is there to serve them, you know. They don't look at a tortoise and think, that's an interesting creature with just as much right to live as me. They think, oh, this is a mode of transport that has been provided for me, probably by my human owners.
And here's another cat who can't be bothered to use its legs. This is Morgan James, who lives in Beaumont, Texas, and the footage he posted of his cat Simon refusing to go for a walk became a cyber smash hit, getting over 2 million views. And whilst most found the disobedient moggy hilarious, it also sparked an online backlash from concerned cat lovers. It all started in early 2014, when Morgan decided his apartment-bound cats should get some exercise.
I wouldn't consider walking cats a normal thing. Obviously, the notion is that you walk dogs, but I've heard lots of stories of people successfully walking their cats and their cats loving it, but Simon's just got that personality where he's stubborn.
Cats cannot be convinced or cajoled into anything, particularly physical exercise. Cats choose to spend most of their time being idle and sleeping. When they want to engage in activity, they do it on their own terms, in their own way. And that is why there is something absolutely absurd about the idea of cat leashes. You cannot take a cat for a walk.
I guess Simon decided that he wasn't gonna walk. Then that's when he kind of just balled up and fell over and was like, all right, well, if you're not gonna let me go where I wanna go, then you're gonna have to drag me. We were just like, Simon, come on, what are you doing? We were laughing a little bit, because he just had that look on his face. So I was kind of giving him gentle tugs to see if he was gonna get up or not. And you know, he's just being an absolute diva.
So, as all people do in the 21st century when they've captured something amusing on their phone, Morgan posted the video on a well-known video sharing site, where the comments soon came flooding in.
When I first started getting popularity on YouTube, there were a variety of comments. The majority of them were overwhelmingly positive, but there are a few of them where people would express displeasure, say that I was hurting my cats or that I shouldn't do that to my cats. A lot of people seem to just assume that Simon's leash was just a leash on a collar, so that it was dragging him by the neck rather than being like his whole body, which in actuality he wasn't. So I think that was the biggest thing that discomforted me whenever I would read negative comments.
It was at this point Morgan decided to respond to the critics by recreating the video with him playing the part of the cat.
I think the fans seemed like they thought it was a pretty clever tongue-in-cheek way of saying, here's me walking a mile in Simon's shoes.
Cats in shoes? Surely that should be puss in boots. Oh, who writes this stuff?
I think for cats that live permanently indoors, if they got used to wearing the harness and walking on the leash and enjoy going out, it can be a very essential thing to do, to, you know, to keep them exercised, to keep them stimulated. But if they don't like it and they're terrified by it, you know, play with them indoors.